Hi, creators! We decided to continue our series of tutorials inspired by video games. So in this tutorial, we are going to create the text intro animation from Call of Duty Modern Warfare. Let's do it! Launch VSDC and create a new project. Add a text object and set its duration. 10 seconds. Double-click on the text and apply the shadow effect. The duration of the effect should be 10 seconds as well. In the Properties window, set the following parameters: Light Angle 0, Shadow Distance 0, Shadow Color green, Shadow Max Size 10, Intensity 10. The foundation of the effect is ready. Time to add animation. Open the text effect menu and select Recoloring. Place the effect at the beginning of the file and set its duration, 3 seconds. Do you think it's ready? Not yet. Let's toggle the settings a bit and see what else we can do here. To make sure the text appears on the screen exactly the way we want, select the following parameters: Effect Duration, Fade In, Processing Order, from first glyph to last, Glyph Drawing Time, 100%. Perfect! Now we are going to animate the symbols. Open the Text Effect menu again and select Glyph Effects. Place the effect at the beginning of the file and set its duration, 3 seconds. At first, it seems nothing's changed, so let's go to the settings. In the Properties window, you need to set the following parameters: Effect Duration, Fade In, Processing Order, from first glyph to last, Glyph Drawing Time, 75%, Transformation Type, Rotate. Now each symbol is kind of being selected before its full appearance. Great job! The text animation part is ready. But if we want this effect to look exactly like the Call of Duty intro, we need it to disappear in a certain way as well. To achieve that, just duplicate the recoloring and the glyph effects layers, then place them at the end of the file. For each effect, set the following parameters: Effect Duration, Fade Out, Processing Order, Random. We're almost done here. It's time to add the sound. Feel free to grab the audio file from the description below and use it in your project. Drag the file to the scene, place it at the beginning of the effect, then in the Properties window, find Loop Mode and select Loop Audio. Stretch it so that the duration of the sound would match the duration of the appearance effect, which is 3 seconds. Remember to duplicate the audio for the last few moments as well. And this is it! Time to add your footage. Hopefully you're happy with the result. Let us know which effects inspire you for creating videos. And remember to subscribe. There's so much more we've prepared for you. Stay tuned.